In this video, I'm going to walk you through how to add custom properties to product library objects. So I'm in settings, and under the data management section here, you can see products. Here's our product library. We've got them in folders. If I go into one of those now, I can see the products that we have here. I'll go into one of these and scroll down. All the normal kind of fields, but then at the bottom, I've got these two custom properties that we have on a product. So how did we add them and how do we manage them? You can go up to here, the properties section. I've got this open in a new tab. Just switch there. Now, when you first go to properties, you probably by default see contact properties, and you might not actually know that you can easily switch between the different objects, including custom objects in your HubSpot database. So you can see company, contact, deal properties. There's also tickets, etc. But I'm actually going to choose product properties here. And then this is all of the product properties. I'll just expand this out so you can see them all. And then if I scroll to the bottom, here's two custom properties that we've added. They're actually in their own group as well, a Zen group. How do we add groups? That's pretty simple. Here, created a Zen group. I could create one up here. I won't do that now. But there's the properties. Let's say I wanted to create a new custom property. I'll click create. Yes, it's in the product. I'll choose the group. Maybe I'll put this in the Zen group as well. Let's call it Zen category. And we'll go through next. I won't save this, but I'll just show you the kind of experience that you get. Pretty similar. You're probably used to this. I'll choose a drop-down select, and then I can add my entries. That's how you create the property, and you can go back in and edit existing ones as well. I'll cancel out. I'm not going to save that there. That's really all I wanted to cover in this quick snapshot, this of how to create custom properties on product library items, and indeed the same approach is for custom properties on any object. Hope that's useful. I'll see you in the next video.